something
maybe,
like that.
Yeah, I don't know.
Maybe.
Then again, maybe he just has all that pulled up and attacks it, and then the mines hit everything, and then he wins the fight anyways.
Yeah.
I don't know. Just food for thought there. So this game, the eBay was planted, and it's...
I was just going to say, Parting doesn't care this game because he went double gas before Byung got there.
Yes, and he also ran his probes down to kill the Nexus to make it look like he was in a big hurry to try to...
Absolutely.
To actually expand there. So
very tricky.
Parting might have taken the opening that's fairly identical, fairly similar to what happened in game one, and he might be able to completely do a counterplay here because, yeah, he's going to go straight into aggression.
Let's see. I think it's going to be an Oracle right off the bat. I mean, there's some small chance it could be Phoenix's. We'll see here in just a moment.
Yeah,
Parting is actually supply blocked.
That's
look at this. 29 of 31.
And there's no...
Oh, Fleet Beacon. Okay, never mind. I was going to say.
Oh, wow. Okay. That's actually not what I was expecting at all, but...
Yeah, no, I definitely did not expect this at all. So, what do you think we're going to see? Because this could literally be anything except Phoenix and Oracle. I'm going to attack the first one.
There's one Tempest being made.
Yeah, we'll see. I really haven't seen anything quite like this. All right. The damage upgrade. Well, I mean... This should be interesting, that's for sure.
Yeah, I don't know what to expect, but again, you know, this is why Parting is very difficult to play against, is he really knows these alternative approaches to the games. And I mean, he's kind of the opposite of Innovation, where if you look at Innovation's play, you basically, you know what to expect, right? And he's very good at what he does, but because Parting has these alternative strategies.
Yeah.
Sometimes the players really don't know the ins and outs of these types of plays.
Yeah, you shouldn't know this one, right?
Maybe this is some gimmick on the ladder in certain areas, but you know, the scary thing about playing against this is that Parting probably knows the way this game looks in all its iterations much more than Byung will have based off his instincts. So
sure.
This is a very cool move. Now, he sends the Tempest out when it's halfway when the second Tempest is going to be finishing here. So they're both going to be getting there roughly the same time. He has a small army underneath the Tempest. That's important because the Tempest needs some cover.
Ah, look at this. Okay, so he clears the way with the Stalker and Adept. And now he's just going to throw it on shield batteries. Okay, so the whole idea is to get his expansion up, but also siege the main base.
Yeah, and so the idea is he can just start to hit the production over here very hard. But this is a lot of SCVs, Marines, and Tank and Cyclone. Is this doable?
Yeah, he doesn't really have much of an army here.
All right, well, you could kind of do this funny kiting play here with the Tempest. It's not the prettiest thing. What worries me is there's so many Marines here. He's unpowered the pylon.
Yeah, now he's gotten all the pylons.
And
if he had shield batteries that were actually up, maybe this becomes more doable?
But I guess he is picking off the army, right? It's just... sort of a funny-looking engagement here.
It is certainly funny-looking.
There are three Tempests here now. Now, I think that's enough with the ground army that you can't really take a fight. Maybe he can make an advancement over here onto the natural. This is actually now going up, so he's zoned out of his own base.
Oh my gosh, look at this. This is so strange to
see. Stim comes in.
All right, well, gonna be able to... target down a lot of those. But look, yeah, with Stim down.
Well, the funny thing is there's no medevac because he's been making Vikings.
Yeah.
But at the same time, the Vikings seem to hold their own against the Tempest, right? You can get Vikings in pairs out faster than you can get a Tempest out here and especially across the map. So I'm not sure what to make of this. I feel like he needs to target down that reactor on the starport.
Yeah, right there.
That's actually really important.
That's a really good point. And actually, I think he wants to get... Okay, he's actually making a siege tank. That's interesting as well. That wasn't what I was expecting. Well, normally against Tempest builds, you really kind of do like to get out Cyclones in their upgrade. But
I do wonder if this is a build that you only do if they spawn on the left side, since you can hit the add-ons while still being in the safety of the area outside the main base.
Yeah, that's kind of interesting. Oh, God, that's a special Depotasis. Oh,
no!
Super supply block now.
Okay, so there's a small number of Marines coming around, and... I'm actually not sure about this for Byung. The small Marine counterattack, I feel like warp-ins, if there's no medevacs there, you just warp stuff in and kill it.
I wonder how many gates he has. I think he's on just two gates.
Oh, I guess that's true. If you're doing Tempest, you don't
have
a lot.
But I guess if you pop a Tempest out, you are going to hold it, right? It's not that many Marines.
I mean, if you don't have medevacs here and you... okay, well, he's actually going to have only one gate that can warp in now.
Okay. Well, he just recalls a bunch of the stalkers, but with Stim, I guess he will be able to erase these.
And not the greatest control here by Pardian in this pretty pivotal moment. He does clean this up. And now it's going to be about trying to curb the damage that's happening over here. Now, the batteries are key, as you can see here. Because that's it. GG. Pardian wins.
Okay. Gotta say Pardian feels favored. Okay, that's proxy Stargate location.
Yeah, this is... so.
That's a Void Ray, I bet.
I think you're right. I don't think it would be Tempest, because that would just be spotted. It just sounds
too slow,
bad.
Right?
Yeah. It sounds bad. Whenever Pardian does anything, I want to try to think of all the different tech possibilities, just because a lot of times he does do one of the weird alternatives. Mm-hmm. But no, I think you're right. It makes more sense to get Void Rays out here. And U-Star just really... This is a funny push here, because a lot of strats... By the way, this is immediately spotted. A lot of strategies are set up to like, I'll push the natural here. Mm-hmm. That'll be the problem.
Yeah.
Like cannon rushes and stuff like that. But this is one that's actually almost focused on the ramp and the structures in the main.
Yeah, that's what it is.
It's a weird concept because there's not many builds that focus on this.
Well,
but basically, he gets a Void Ray out here. He can separate the main from the natural if he gets enough presence over there. He has batteries on the low ground and enough ranged units. And, you know, Terran is trying to just, you know, get a base up as quick as possible. You just have enough that it's hard for the flimsy Terran units to kind of come out and fight.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be really about retaining Cyclones, I think, right?
I think you're correct.
It feels like just getting the Cyclone upgrade and getting Cyclones out is probably the way to do it. It's like the only way to deal damage quickly enough. We'll see. Okay, here comes the very first Void Ray. Look at this. This is really tough with the shield batteries right there.
Yeah, and you can see the Marines come out and try to do damage, and really they're just draining some of the energy off of the battery. Now the Adepts can come in. Keep in mind, Terran's about to be supply blocked when this depot is killed. There's not another depot coming here. Okay, he's just now started it.
Yeah, he's making a couple, but...
And he can actually get the Marine, I think. Oh, no, never mind.
He is getting a Cyclone out, but is this too little too late?
Now, again, the ramp is now under control by the Protoss. It's a very weird game. The Cyclone's out. Now, again, he wants to run back with the Void Ray. And he's going to actually target that down. That was beautiful play.
That
is the most important unit right now.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Is he...
Okay, this is...
If he got the tech lab, like, there's nothing left.
Yeah, well, I think he's going to get that Artosis.
He is going to get it.
Wait, make up your mind.
Yeah, no, he should target the tech lab.
Okay, he gets that.
Oh.
Going for the factory. The Cyclone's going to pop out. Now, I think there might be another Void Ray. That's it. GG.
That's
parting. Evil wins again.
Evil wins again.